Hello, my name is Miguel, and I work for the Systems Management Group at Dell. Today, we will be going over the Dell troubleshooting tool that is integrated into OpenManage Enterprise. To use the troubleshooting tool, your OpenManage Enterprise appliance will need to be at version 3.9 or above. Earlier versions do not have the same functionality. To check which version of OpenManage Enterprise is deployed, click on the information icon on the top right corner of the OpenManage Enterprise web interface. In this instance, I am using version 3.10.2, which is the latest at the time of this video. To access the troubleshooting tool, click on Monitor and then Troubleshoot. The purpose of the troubleshooting tool is test protocols for device connectivity, test internet connectivity from the appliance to the Dell website, test connection to remote shares, either CIFS or NFS, capture logs, and enable FSD access. The default section is a device view. To understand how to use this tool, it is useful to understand which protocols OpenManage Enterprise uses to connect to the device. For example, OpenManage Enterprise uses the SNMP protocol to connect to Dell switches and uses WS-MAN and RedFish protocols to connect to PowerEdge servers. To test connectivity, type in the IP address of the device you would like to test. In this case, I will go ahead and copy an IP address for one of the drives I've already opened for this example. You can toggle additional settings by clicking on the Additional Settings toggle menu. The options are increasing the number of retries and increasing the timeout value, which is 60 seconds by default. Once you're ready, click on the Test button. The results will be shown on the bottom. In this case, OpenManage Enterprise was successfully able to connect to the iDRAC. You can also test by protocol by clicking the Test Protocol option. In this case, I will reuse the same IP address for testing. Because it is an iDRAC, I will select WS-MAN from the menu, and I will enter the pertinent credentials. You can configure additional settings if you desired. For example, the number of retries, the timeout value if you expect latency, or the port number. By default, though, WS-MAN uses 443, and RedFish also uses port 443. If you would like to enable common name certificate checks and certificate authority checks, you can select those options as well. Once you're ready, press the Test button. As before, the results will be shown on the bottom. I can test successfully using WS-MAN. The next protocol I will test is RedFish. The credential options will reset, but my IP address remains. Once I type in the desired username and IDRAC password, I can then select the additional options if needed, and then click on Test. As before, the results will be shown on the bottom. In this case, I have also tested successfully using RedFish. Next, we will go over the option for testing internet connectivity for the appliance. Internet connectivity is required for downloading update catalogs, firmware updates, warranty information, or connectivity to Cloud IQ or services plugins. To test OME internet connectivity, click on Appliance on the left context menu. From the Sites drop-down menu, select the relevant site or all sites. Press the Test button, and the results will be shown on the bottom. In this example, I have successfully tested connectivity to the Dell Warranty Information website and also to the Dell Online website. On this section, you can also restart the appliance by toggling to the Restart Appliance option and then clicking on the blue button that says Restart Appliance. This will cycle the OpenManage Enterprise appliance. This process can take anywhere from 10 to 20 minutes, depending on how many services are running and how many plugins are loaded into the appliance. shares in OpenManage Enterprise are used for offline catalogs and for appliance backups. You can test OpenManage Enterprise connections to shares by clicking on the Network Share option on the left. There will be two options to connect shares. One will be CIFS or NFS. For CIFS, you will be required to present the IP address, the network path, the domain information, the username, and the password. You can also test connectivity to NFS shares by providing the IP address and the path. Once you have entered the correct information, you can click on Test Now. For this example, I have successfully connected to NFS share. Logs can be gathered from the log section on this troubleshooting section. To generate a log, you will need to click on the Generate Log button. The OpenManage Enterprise log bundle will include logs from any sub-plugins, such as the Services plugin, OMUB, or CloudIQ. This process can take anywhere from 2 minutes to approximately 10 minutes, depending on how many plugins are installed and if debug mode is enabled. Once the logs finish generating, you can click on Download Log. This process can also take anywhere from a couple of minutes to approximately 20 minutes, depending on the size of the download. Debug logging can be enabled by accessing the OpenManage Enterprise appliance on your guest VM on your hypervisor. For my example, I have already opened the guest console, and I will need to scroll down to the Setup Debug Logging menu option. Once it's selected, press Enter, and then press Enter on Enable All Debug Logs. Once debug logging has been enabled, you can confirm by going back to OpenManage Enterprise and clicking on Home. There will be a banner showing that debug logging has been enabled. If you're using this for troubleshooting purposes, you will need to reproduce the behavior that you're trying to catch. And then once this is completed, go back to Monitor, Troubleshoot option, and then click on Logs, Generate Log, Download Log. The next section includes Dell technical support for troubleshooting purposes. This is for the section called FSD. To enable field service debug mode, it will need to be enabled by accessing the OpenManage Enterprise Appliance guest VM on your hypervisor. To enable field service debug mode FSD, scroll down to Enable Field Service Debug Mode and then press Enter. Press Enter to unblock FSD capabilities. By default, FSD can only be enabled for 1 month. Press Tab to select Generate and then press Enter. FSD is now enabled, and this can be confirmed by going to the Home section in OpenManage Enterprise. You can also follow the instructions provided on the screen. To confirm, go back to OpenManage Enterprise and click on Home, and there will be a yellow banner stating that FSD mode has been enabled. For the next part, we'll need to click on Monitor and then Troubleshoot. Click on FSD and then click on Download that file. On your browser, because of security restrictions, you may need to click on Skip. This will finish the download process and it will be available on your downloads folder. You will then need to provide this file. Dell technical support will then provide further instructions. This completes the overview of the troubleshoot section in OpenManage Enterprise.